you enjoy that?
Yes.
So from London, we're taking a trip to Paris next. Of course, where every woman wants to go for Christmas. Gents, if they start saying you want to go to a jewellery shop, run. So this next song is a lovely piece of music that was written by George Gershwin in 1928. And it is a jazz-inspired piece by Paris in 1951. It was used in a movie by the same name, featured Jean Carey and Leslie Carroll. Hope you enjoy this. This is a lovely selection of music from an American in Paris. Or as we call it, a Taffin Ponty.
Thank you.
and Emma, our trumpet solo from American in Paris. So we're going to do our first Christmas number. Now this might not be one you may recognise. Some of you will, some of you won't. Hands up who's over the age of 21. So three of you. Right. Should have chosen a different piece than you won't know Frozen. Sorry, it's not Frozen. This next piece is a selection of music from one of the greatest all-time Christmas movies ever made. No, not Frozen, that's tomorrow. The movie was Home Alone. But we didn't want to do the first one, so we thought we'd do the second one. So we've jumped back on a plane and gone back to New York. Because that's where Christmas is best spent, isn't it? Around the Christmas tree in a hotel. The film features a great cast, including the great comedy actor Tim Curry. I hope you enjoy this. It's a selection of music from Home Alone 2, Lost.
Thank you.
movie should have come out, and it was made famous by a lovely female singer called Billie Eilish. This is the theme tune from the new James Bond movie, No Time to Die, which we've all waited for years and years and years and years and years. Sure, Roger Moore started in it, and Daniel Craig ended in it, but one of those two. I hope you enjoyed this. This is a lovely arrangement done for Wynn Vance of No Time.
Thank you.
song. Right, should I give you a secret? This next song, I have a legacy, and I was hoping they wouldn't have noticed, but they did. This next song was made famous by a band called The Pogues. It's a fairy tale in New York. I was hoping you wouldn't have noticed, but you all did. Oh, I thought I got away with that. I was giving a Christmas present to her.
Thank you.
Can we have a round of applause for Father John for his song? Now, our next piece is one we thought we'd bring to a bit early. In June of next year, we are doing a night of the movies across the road in the church hall. And this is one of the pieces we'll be playing. It's from a movie, it's a World War II movie called The Fourth Main Parallel. And it's been such a gorgeous venue, it's only favourite playing today as well. It's a lovely piece called The Crowning of the 49th Parallel. I hope you enjoy it. It's a lovely little hidden type piece. So this next song is a Bing Crosby classic. We've sung it enough today, love of it. Oh, it's not that bad, is it? They get better, I promise. After my four brandies, they're brilliant. This next song is a lovely one, and we'll play the first verse, and then if you want to join in the second time around, please do. This is Bing Crosby's White Christmas.
Thank you.
of a challenge, a Christmas jumper challenge. We don't normally wear this on stage. We're normally a bit smarter. Well, some. Some are ringing Doc Wong for on the weekend. Someone's phone's going. Whose phone is ringing? That's a £50 fine. Your band member. No. That's Simon Cowell, I'm not interested. I am. So we set the band a challenge that they have to not only perform well today, but they have to dress up in Christmas jumpers. So we've done two categories. We've got an adult category and a child's category. Now, when I say a child, is under 18. How many of you are under 18?
Yes.
So, we'll do the under 18s first. So I'm going to pass it over to Parlour John. I follow my own music sense.
Well, no disrespect to the rest of the band, but I can only see one under 18, so congratulations.
Now we're going to hand you over to the best adults. Now I'm excluding myself from this. Because, I know my love. Chapter didn't even make it from Merthyr. So, Father John, how do you want to do this? Do you want us to go and get all stand up for you?
I think we'll do a bit of a wave. We'll start
right,
at
the back. Back, back, wave.
Stand up.
All right. Okay.
I need to see your jumpers. Oh, I see another Star Wars fan.
Trumpet, stand up.
People, but they're usually church members, so this is slightly different. But and I didn't think I'd be saying this in church, but there's one member of the band here who has magnificent baubles. And so I present the prize here.
Can I just say what a pleasure it's been to work with you guys? I said 9 weeks ago I came in and took over from our previous MD who couldn't be here today, which is a shame. For the work they've done to get this concert up and running in the short period they've done, it's been fantastic. Come on, a round of applause. Let's say hello. So we're going to finish with a lovely little Christmas number. Have you all enjoyed yourselves?
Yeah.
This piece is written by Leroy Anderson and features some great little Christmas themes. And apologies to Frosty the Snowman, I didn't win the chocolates. But Frosty, it's a hoodie, not a jumper.
It's a jumper!
We're going to leave you with some lovely little pieces, and this is Leroy Anderson's Christmas Festival.
Thank you.
follow that, as they say. I'm sure you'll agree it's been an absolutely magnificent afternoon. When I planned this originally, I just had a vague idea that we'd get the community together and sing a few carols. And it just grew and grew. And I'm so pleased that it has, because it's been magnificent. I want to say a few thank yous before we all leave today, but also to ask Jill if she can bring some of these up, because these tell you where all the services are in all of our four churches over the next few days as we begin to celebrate this great feast of Christmas. So if you'd like to know where any of our services are in any of our four churches, then please take one of these as you leave. And there's an ulterior motive for me asking Jill to do this, because this is the lady who made the mulled wine. And I'm sure it was purely coincidental that after we drank the mulled wine, our carol singing was much better. So my thanks to Jill for helping with that. To all the parishioners from St. Mary's and throughout our four churches who so generously provided all the mince pies for us. We still have a number of them left. As you leave, and we have to leave this way because it's one way in, one way out. Welcome to COVID Church. So as you leave and you come through this way to do so, there's a trolley just as you near the exit, and there's packs of mince pies that are open.
You're very welcome
to take as many as you like. As you can see from my rather Father Christmas shape, I've probably had too many of them already. So you do me a huge favour if you take at least one more each. But Geraint, thank you very much. It's been tremendous. And once again, would you all please stand and raise your... you can't raise your glasses. Give a round of applause.
We haven't planned it, actually, we didn't take you on long, but it's been an absolute pleasure. As I said, these guys have worked really hard over the last 6 weeks to get today. They've earned a nice break now, so they're back in band on Monday. We're a month off now, and then they'll be straight back in, getting ready to run night at the movies to take place in Church Hall. When we spoke to Father John about our concert next year, we'd love to see as many people from the community there, because what we're actually doing, whoever comes and buys a ticket, we are donating the proceeds from each ticket to the church. Alright? So, because it's a lovely venue, as you've seen. And it's been an absolute pleasure for me and for the band to come and perform today. So we're going to do this little encore with We Wish You a Merry Easter.